To my new lecture. In this lecture, I am going to talk about median, mod, quantiles, deciles, and percentiles. In the previous lecture, as we have discussed the different types of central tendency, that of arithmetic mean, geometric mean, harmonic mean, along with other different parameters. Now we would continue with our discussion about the central tendency, with more averages like median, mod, and all these different things. First of all, I would like to discuss the median. Median represents the middle value of a data set. Median is defined as a value which divides a data set that have been ordered into two equal parts, one part comprising of observations greater than and the other part smaller than that middle value. Basically, it divides data into 50% on one side and 50% on the other side. So median is middle value, and one thing to remember in the case of median is that first you have to arrange the data in some order, in an order fashion. Now suppose you have observations x1, x2, up to xn observation of which you want to calculate the median of. Now first you have to consider whether n by 2 is an integer or not an integer, right? When n by 2 is an integer, the procedure of median would be different, and when n by 2 is not an integer, and by integer you know that integer means 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, these are all integers. Z is set of integers which is 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, all these are integers. So first you have to consider whether n by 2 is an integer or not an integer. When n by 2 is an integer, then median is calculated as the average of, means n by 2th plus n by 2 plus 1th observation divided by 2. This is the average of the n by 2th observation and n plus 1 by 2th observation. This gives the median when it is an integer, right? Now when n by 2 is not an integer, the middle value or median is calculated by n plus 1 by 2th observation, right? You have to calculate median, if it is an integer, by this value, n by 2th value plus n by 2 plus 1th value, average over it, right? And for the case it is not an integer, the median is calculated simply by n plus 1 by 2th value, right? For the case of group data, how you will calculate the median for group data? Median for group data is calculated first using the, you will find out the median clause in group data, and median clause will be find out once again by the n by 2 consideration that we have already made. So for calculating the median of a group data, first you need to find out the median class. And median class is basically the class where n by 2th value lies, right? जिसके अंदर n by 2th value जो है, जिस class interval के अंदर आ रही होगी, वो जो है median class कहलाएगी. Now the median for this group data can be found out. You have to make sure as well that you have to basically calculate cumulative frequency as well for calculating the median. So the median would be, in case of group data, L plus H over F n by 2 minus C, where L is the lower class boundary of median class and H is size of class interval as told before, F is frequency of the median class and N is number of observations and C is cumulative frequency preceding the median class. So when you find out all these values and substitute in this equation, you will get the median of your data. First you have to look into the median class to calculate this value, right? And one thing you should note that the uniform class interval is not required for calculating the median. Now I would look into the two examples, one for ungrouped data and the other for grouped data, to find the median of, to explain the procedure. This is my example for the ungrouped data. Given below are marks of 9 students, which are given as these, find median. Now first thing I have to do is to arrange the data in an order. The lowest value is, first would be 32, then value is 36, then 37, then 36 is twice, I believe, 36, then it is 37, then 39, then 41, then 45, then 46, and then 48. First, I have arranged this data in order, right? I will find the n by 2th, n by total number. There are 9 observations and 9 by 2 is 4.5, which is not an integer. So I have to calculate this by the formula. When n by 2 is not an integer, then median is given by n by 2th value, means plus n plus 1 by 2th observation divided by an average of it. This would be n by 2 is 4.5 plus n by 2 plus 1 is 5.5, and divided by 2 will make it 4.5 and 10. This would be fifth observation. Now the fifth observation in this case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So my median in this case is fifth observation, which is 39. This is how you calculate the median. Now let's do an example. Find the median of the marks obtained by the students. The data is given in the group form, and the class intervals are given over here, and number of students are given. Number of students, we can call this as frequency, which we would represent by F. And first, as these class boundaries are not matching, these one upper and the lower of the next, so first we have to match them. This would be matched, as I told earlier, difference divided by 2, and add up over here and subtract it from here. So this would become let's say 29.5 to 39.5, and this would also, as they will match, so 39.5 to 49.5, and this would be 49.5 to 59.5, and this would be 59.5 to 69.5, and this would be 69.5 to 79.5, this would be 79.5 to 89.5, and 89.5 to 99.5. If they are already matching, then you do not have to do this. If they are not matching, then you have to adopt this procedure. So another thing, for the case of medium, I have to calculate the cumulative frequency for this data. I have to calculate the cumulative frequency, which comes out to be 8, and it would be 95, and it would be 285. You have to add the previous values. 285 plus 304 would be 589 plus 211 would be 800. 800 plus 85 would be 885, and 885 plus 20 would be 905. This is my cumulative frequency. Now I have to choose the median class. For the median class, I need n. N in this case is the basically summation f, in this case is n, and summation f is 905. So this is my n, right? Now n divided by 2th value, or n by 2th value, this would be 905 over 2 would be 402.5. now this 402.5 value lies in whichever class interval, that would be the known as the median class. This lies, this 402.5 lies in this case, right? So this is my, this class would be considered as my median class, right? This would be my median class. In other case, you can solve according to situation. Now I have to find the lower class boundary. L in this case would be 59.5, H in this case is 10, and F, frequency of the median class, is 304 in this case, and n already we know is 905, and cumulative frequency preceding the median class is 285. When you put all these values in the, while calculating the median, which is given as L plus H over F, n by 2 minus C will give you the result, which comes out to be in this case the median is 65 marks. And this median is very important while doing the relative grading of the students. Next, we move towards calculating, and what is mode? Mode is the value which occurs most frequently in a set of data. It indicates the most common result. A set of data may have more than one mode or no mode at all when each observation occurs the same number of times. जब observation जो है repeated जो observations हैं वो same number of time होंगी तो उसका हो सकता है कोई mode ना हो, right? However, for the case of ungrouped data, mode is most repeated or frequently occurring value. By looking at the data which we considered in the previous example, if I am able to show you that data, this one, this data, it was, what should be the mode? Mode is the most repeated value, and 36 has repeated twice in this case. So one will see that mode for that data would be 36. Now, how to calculate the mode for group data? For group data, the mode is given by L plus Fm minus F1 over Fm minus F1 plus Fm minus F2 multiplied by H. This is mode for the case of group data, where L is the, as in previous case, lower class boundary, right? F sub of M is frequency of model class, right? And F1 is the frequency model class, let's say if I represent with MC is model class, frequency preceding model class, and F2 is frequency following the model class, right? F2 is frequency following the model class, and H is size of class interval, right? These are the different variables that represent the mod, right? And there is another formula for calculating the mod, which is, mod can also be calculated using the formula L plus F2 over F1 plus F2 multiplied by H. Now, how to find out the model class? The class having the maximum frequency is known as the model class. Suppose the data that we were considering in previous example, the highest frequency was 304, so this class would be known as model class. Now, lower class boundary, you can find out the frequency preceding the model class is 190 and frequency following the model class is 211, and you put these values over here and you will get the mode of this group data. So I leave these calculation to you people. You can easily find them out by using these formulas. Next we look at the relationship between the mean, median and mod, which are part of the measure of central tendency or the measure of averages. This would be empirical relationship between mean, median and mod, as all of these quantities represent the central tendency or averages. You can say that mean minus mod is equals to 3 mean minus median, or simply you can say that mod is equals to 3 median minus 2 mean. So once you know two of these quantities, you can easily find the third one using these formulas. Next I want to move towards the topic of quartiles, right? Quartiles basically divides the data into three portion, which one of them is Q1, the other one is Q2, and the third one is Q3. Q2 is same as median, right? Q1 is known as first lower quartile, while Q3 is known as third or upper quartile. देखें, जब डेटा जो है वो लार्ज होता है तो बजाय इसके कि मीडियन से हम लें, हम जो है लोअर जो है वो क्वार्टाइल, अपर क्वार्टाइल और Q2 से जो है वो उनको मॉडल कर सकते हैं, और इसलिए परसेंटाइल्स और डिसाइल्स भी यूज़ होते हैं, क्योंकि जब डेटा बहुत ज़्यादा लार्ज होता है तो फिर डेटा की डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन को जो है वो ज़्यादा बेहतर ऑब्ज़र्व करने के लिए जो है ये क्वार्टाइल्स, डिसाइल्स और परसेंटाइल्स यूज़ की जाती हैं। जैसे कि आप जो है वो परसेंटाइल अपने अगर NTS का टेस्ट वगैरह दें तो उसके अंदर परसेंटाइल भी लिखी होती है। यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट दिस Q1, Q2 एंड Q3। Q2 इज एज आई टोल्ड अर्लियर दैट सेम एज मीडियन। Q1 इज कैलकुलेटेड by considering the n by 4 of an of the data, and Q1 is n by 4. You calculate first whether c, the n by 4th value, is an integer or not. Similarly, then you adopt the formula whether it when it is an integer or not an integer, as you have considered in case of the median. And similarly, Q3 is calculated by considering the 3n by 4th value, whether it is an integer or a not an integer, right? We see an example this is and for the case of group data, the formula of calculating the Q1, Q2 and Q3 remains the same. Now we would see it in by taking an example. First, the number of cars crossing a certain bridge in a big city in 10 intervals of 5 minutes each were recorded. The number of cars were recorded to be 15, 25, 15, 18, 30, 20, 20, 12, 9, 16, and 15. Now the number of first I have to order these observation, they would be 12, 15, 15, there is also 9, then 12, then 15, 15, and then there is 16, and then 18, then 20, 20, and 30. So these are one entry is missing, it should be 25 and 30. Now this is my ordered data, and first I would see the n by 2 2th value, right? This is the so it comes out as an integer. So my Q2 would be n by 2th value means 10 by 5th value. 5th value is 16, and the 6th value, which is 18 divided by 2, this comes out to be 17. So Q2 is 17 in this case. Now to calculate Q1 and Q3, to calculate the Q1, I have to see the n by 4th value, and n is 10, and 10 by 4 would be 2.5 n by 4, which comes out to be 2.5, right, for Q1, right, which is not an integer. So my Q1 would be n by 4 plus 1th value, right, which comes out n by 4 is 2.5, and 2.5 plus 1. Now this n by 4 is 2.5. 2.5, you have to consider this as 2, and 2 plus 1 is 3rd value, right? So the 3rd value in this case is 15. And for the case of for Q3, you have to 3 n by 4, 3 into 10 is 30 over 4, that comes out to be 7.5, which is also not an integer, right? So you will calculate this Q3 to be 3 n by 4 plus 1th value. 3 n by 4, as we have seen, is 7.5, which will you will take as 7, and plus 1 is 8th value. So 8th value in our ordered is 20. So Q3 is 20. This is how you calculate the quartiles. Now, just like the quartiles divide the data into four equal parts with intervals Q1, Q2 and Q3, decile divide the data into 10 equal parts, right, with deciles ranging from D1, D2, D3 up to D9. And similarly, percentiles has 99 parts and they basically make up 100 equal parts and they are from P1, P2 up to P99. And you can say that the third quartile, right, is equals to 6th decile and 60th percentile, right? And these are related somehow, right? The percentile, any percentile PJ can be found out by J times N over 100, and any deciles can be found out by J times N over 10, right? This is how you calculate the decile and percentile. Now, when you talk about percentile, first you have to see whether this quantity is an integer, right? If this particular value is an integer, then you have to, the PJ would be observation with ordinal number J n by 100 plus 1, right? And when this PJ is equals to J n over 100 is, sorry, this is for the case of not an integer, and when it is integer, then it is given by, the PJ is given by average of J n by 100 and J n by 100 plus 1 values, right, or ordinals, right? The example that we just considered, if we want to calculate, let's say, P10 from that data, then we have to first multiply this 10 and the number of observation in that example were also 10 over 100. This means that it comes out as an integer. So if we are interested in calculating the P10, then JN over 100 means first, JN is all 100, first n plus second observation and average them out, right? First observation in our data that we just considered was, if I could, so P10 would be, first observation is 9 and the second observation is 12. So the P10 would be 9 plus 12 divided by 2. So the percentile for this data comes out to be 10.5. Similarly, you can find different deciles and percentiles using the given formula. I would suggest you to do some exercises and solve examples related to percentiles and deciles just to clear the meaning of these terms in your mind. आप लाजमी जो है वो कुछ डाटा लेके ग्रुप्ड और अनग्रुप्ड डाटा जो है वो सॉल्व करें इनको परसेंटाइल डिसाइल्स और क्वार्टाइल्स के लिए और बुक से कंसल्ट करें तो आपको काफ़ी बेहतर समझ आएगी. इन द एंड आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक यू ऑल फॉर योर टाइम. आई वुड बी बैक सून विद ए न्यू लेक्चर.